Oh, hey there, Beatle fans.
It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel alright. When I'm home, everything seems to be right. When I'm home, feeling you holding me tight, tight, yeah. Oh, it's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel alright. You know I feel alright. You know I feel alright.
You just caught me reading one of my favorite magazines, Teen Vogue. And, oh my god, it's the Beatles! They're in my magazine! That's so amazing, so cool, and what? Inspiration indeed. How do you guys feel about this? I don't know what to feel anymore. I mean, I don't hate the kid at all by any means. I have no reason to. I don't like his music very much. I don't listen to his music, and I'm getting tired of his face, but that's about it. The thing that gets to me most, however, is the fact they call him Power Pop Prince. He is not power pop. He's like R&B and pop, not power pop. Power pop is the Beatles. Power pop is Badfinger. Power pop is the Raspberries and Big Star and all these other people. He's not power pop. Lies. I'm not very thrilled about these either. So today in Beatley Headlines, Gibson is releasing three guitars inspired by the life and music of John Lennon. The first of which is a beautiful tobacco sunburst guitar that John bought in around 1963 and used for the albums Please Please Me, With the Beatles, and A Hard Day's Night. There is a video of him, I'm sure there are quite a few videos of him, but the one that sticks out in my head in which he uses the guitar is this one where the song Misery is playing in the background and they're in the studio just having a good time. I'll post that in the doobly-doo for you all. The second one is a guitar inspired by Imagine. It's white and I want it. It is my favorite. It's beautiful. And the third guitar is one with a natural finish. It has John's caricatures of himself and Yoko on the lower body of the guitar. It's a remake of the one that John used on the Bedding for Peace rallies. I'd love to have all three of them if I could, if they were in $10,000 to $15,000 each. Happy Paul's dead anniversary, my friends! Yesterday in Beatles history, it is said that the Paul is dead rumor had started in 1969. This started when a New York disc jockey expressed his opinions on whether Paul McCartney was alive or not. I'm not sure if he said it as speculation or if it was a fact that he was dead. But he said it. And a newspaper article in Iowa of this little university decided to elaborate on his findings by pointing out all the clues that the Beatles did starting from the Sgt. Pepper albums. I'm not gonna go into detail because I believe there's maybe two or three videos already up on this channel about Paul is Dead, so go check those out if you're curious. Paul McCartney's producing his son's debut EP called Available Light. It has been recorded over the past 2 years in the United States and the United Kingdom, including some sessions at Abbey Road Studios. So I'll post a link to that article, and I'm looking forward to it. I got a text message.
I hate you!
What do I hate? Sorry, I'm covering your name. My cousin is at the Imagine Mosaic. I hate you! Oh my god! I could have gone today, but I have work at 5 and it would have been, you know, New York's about 2 hours away by train, and it would have been cutting it close. And I hate her! I hate her! I'm so jealous. I'm so happy for her at the same time. OMG, I hate you. Oh, it's not in caps lock. Vanessa, you are so lucky. Okay, so it's time for some Beatley randoms. First of all, I got a cool Beatles notebook a couple weeks ago from Walmart. Thank you to Abby for letting me know about the whole Walmart sale. Unfortunately, this is the only one I could find. After an hour of digging, I'm not even kidding, I spent an hour there just looking for Beatles stuff because I'm crazy. I bet you can tell I'm already crazy because, you know, I just screamed at my cell phone, "I hate you!" I lowered the volume for your convenience. Tons of Justin Bieber stuff. One Beatle thing. That says something. I'm a huge fan of embellishing things with pins, so here's my latest creation that still needs some work. My backpack messenger bag thingamajiggy. Last week, I proposed a challenge for all the Beatle fans. Yes, that includes not only the Beatle scruffs, but you guys out there. You can make a video response or something and show us your Beatle-y artwork. Something inspired by one of your favorite songs or just any song in general. It could be the Beatles singing in the studio or at a concert, or it could be just like a whole... What? Okay. It could be a whole kind of mess of colors, just anything. And unfortunately, I didn't even fulfill this challenge, so I'm going to do that for next Saturday because I fail at life. Speaking of next Saturday, that's when I'll see you next. So... bye, Beatle fans. Have a wonderful week. Thanks for watching. Comment, rate, Formspring, Facebook. I'll post a link to my personal Formspring if you have any questions for me. Bye!